So you got yourself a Sordin Supreme Mil CC Slim, a bumper ballistic helmet and some adapters, or at least you're planning to get all of this. And now you're questioning, how do I need to put them all together? Well, look no further, because we'll explain it all to you with this video. If you want to support me and my brother's work and this channel, make sure to subscribe and hit the bell button to stay notified. And also visit our website ReconBrothers.com for our blogs and webshop. All the stuff that we show here in this video is available through our shop, and more quality products can be found over there as well. Before we go into explaining the whole process, we first want to notify you on what options you have available and what you need to look out for. The very first thing you need to know is that the Sordin Supreme Mil CC Slim comes in three possible configurations. One being with a leather headband, another option with a neck band, and they can also come directly with helmet adapters. For all of these, you need to be aware of a few things first. Let's begin with the leather headband. This one is specially designed to be very slim and thus allows to be used underneath a helmet. Only issue with this is that there isn't always a comfortable way to use it together with a helmet its retention system, especially due to the microphone. So the most convenient and comfortable way is to mount it onto the helmet. Now, in order to get this done, you do need to cut a leather wrap in order to free the cable connecting the two ear cups. This renders the headband totally useless, but don't worry, you can get a textile headband wrap from a third-party company or from Sordin themselves to use the bridge again. This way you'll be able to switch between a helmet or headband setup rather quickly if you need to do so. So that's one option. Another one is the neckband version, which is probably the best neckband designed out there when it comes to these sort of systems. This is of course nice, but a neckband version doesn't allow to be mounted onto a helmet. At least Sordin doesn't provide a solution for this themselves. We however do know there are third-party companies that make adapters available for these. These are not easy to mount, and a quick interchange between the helmet and neckband setup is not possible. Aside that, doing it like this brings up another issue, but we'll cover that problem in a bit. The last option you have is when your Sordin comes with adapters straight from the factory. This is of course only useful if you consider to use the headset on a helmet solely, meaning you cannot go back to a headband, for example. The adapter Sordin provides for these are for ARC style of rails, and yes, that is important to know because not all helmets have the same rail types. In fact, there are three possible versions. One are the ARC, aka accessory rail connectors, which ones originate from Obscore and which are the most common ones out there. Then you have Team Windy with their unique rails, and at last you also have the pretty rare M-Lock style of rails. Since these are all different, you will require adapters that fit both that specific type of rail and the Sordin headset, of course. Now, as for ARC rails, it's quite simple. These are available from Sordin themselves. Team Windy adapters are currently not available from Sordin, but we know these adapters are currently under development. However, there are already adapters available on the market for Team Windy rails, and those are made by Unity Tactical. But as said earlier, there is an issue with third-party adapters in general, which Sordin has warned us for. The thing is that these products are being engineered to comply with the high demands they need to be rated for. And for this, companies like Sordin work together with the helmet manufacturers themselves to guarantee things like a good seal for all compatible helmet models. Now, the issue with those third-party companies that create their own solutions is the fact that you mostly can't find proof that they ensure those ratings. So even though they might be more expensive and provide you with more features, it's totally possible that your ears aren't that well protected by using them like this. So that's just a fair warning for you to keep in mind. At last, an M-Lock version currently only exists by Unity Tactical 2, but the chance you have such a system is still rather low. Aside all this, the very last things you should know about is that only a Sordin Supreme Mil CC with slim cups can be converted to a helmet mounted setup. And for those that are looking for a way to mount a Supreme Pro X onto a helmet, that is officially not possible according to Sordin. So now that you are aware of this and you have your headset, helmet and the correct adapters, let's go over to mounting this thing. As an example here, we will show you the mounting of the Sordin headband headset onto a Sestambush ballistic helmet that has ARC type of rails with the Sordin Supreme ARC adapters. So the first thing you want to do is cut the leather headband entirely off the bridge. After that, you can screw the arms loose and pull the arms of the cups. It may require some force to pull them off. This way you now have a separate bridge and two loose cups. Next, attach the cups on the arms of the adapters. Make sure they are leveled and screw them hand tight. The last step is to mount them with their adapters onto the helmet, but before doing this you want to consider where you're going to place the wire connecting the two cups. Here you have two options. Either you place the wire on the outside of the helmet, which is best done underneath a helmet cover, or you place it on the inside somewhere behind the padding of the helmet so it doesn't create uncomfortable pressure points. Once you've decided how to do this, you can mount the adapters on its rails. After that, the only thing left for you to do is to adjust them to your size, and then you're ready to roll. So guys, hope this guide was helpful to you. If you're looking for these sort of products, don't look any further and go visit shop.ReconBrothers.com. Make sure to leave a like. Thanks for watching, and you'll see us next week again.